Now we are taking up a couple of random topics that I think you might need for short notes. They haven't asked any of these questions till now, but as a part of maybe 10 marker or short 5 markers, if they tend to go that way. So this could be important concepts for sake of completion. Again, I'm focusing on the topics under channel morphology and channel morphometry. Before that, I want to briefly explain what is the scope of channel morphology and what do I mean by channel morphometry. Now see, there are four ways of studying any river or a fluvial systems. When I say four ways, one of which we understand, where rivers are an agent of denudation. Rivers erode, river deposits, there are landforms related to erosion and deposition by the rivers. So river as an agent of denudation, that is one type of study of rivers. The second type of study of rivers is river and how they impact landscape development. Now, landscape development is not like studying a river as an agent of erosion alone. Landscape development is in terms of how the entire area's landscape is developed, including the idea of slope analysis. So we have slope models here, Davis model, Pink's model. We do have reference to rivers even in Gilbert's model. We have reference to rivers in the studies of L.C. King also, or any fluvial system. So that's another. We're studying river as a part of model of landscape development. Now, the third way of studying a river is studying a river as a part of a large area in terms of its tributary systems, smaller rivers, and what they do and how they relate among themselves. It's like, imagine river Ganga along with its tributaries and their sub-tributaries. From where does the whole river system take its water? How does the river Ganga, main river stream Ganga, relate to Kosi and Gandak and Ghagra with Sarda, okay, and the upstream source systems? This type of studies was called as channel morphometry. And the fourth way of studying, so channel morphometry is about studying the entire drainage basin. The focus is not only on one stream, it's about the entire drainage basin. And the fourth way of studying a river is studying the river and its specific aspects like the river's width, the river's depth, the amount of water in the river and the way it deposits along the banks, along the its floor. River and how can it shift a river, how does it meander? So that is about a very specific river or a specific channel. The study of drainage basin in entirety is what's called as drainage morphometry, and the study of the river in specific, okay, is what's called as channel morphology. So in channel morphology, we will study channel width, channel drainage, channel wetted perimeter, channel depth, the channel load, channel shifting, okay, the type of course of the channel, that is channel morphology. Now your syllabus mentions channel morphology, but I have a feeling that channel morphometry can also be important. Like one aspect of study of channel morphometry is studying rivers as a part of a larger drainage basin. You can look up one of the earlier videos where I have discussed the idea of channel morphometry also as a part of drainage basin. Now, I've taken up a couple of terms. All these terms are part of, again, basin or channel morphometry, which includes the concept of stream ordering, the concept of bifurcation ratio, and the concept of law of stream numbers. I'm not looking at an in-depth study of all this. That's enough probably for a 20-30 word short note so that you don't get trapped in case they ask you. Now, basin morphometry or channel stream morphometry essentially is about studying three things. Here I have discussed Okay, the ways in which rivers or channels can be studied. Now, I am discussing very specifically the concept of channel morphometry and what does it study. I am not studying channel morphology right now. So, under channel or basin morphometry, there are three things we study. One is what's called as the linear aspect. The linear aspect of basin morphometry is about the river length, okay, the river segment, and how does it relate to other river lengths and other river segments. Like, these three concepts are part of the linear aspects. Then we have areal aspects, where we study the area of the drainage basin, its size, its expanse, okay, what does it comprise. And third is the relief aspects, the landscape with its elevations, with depressions, the valleys, the mountains. So relief aspect includes lot of measurement, lot of calculation, using statistical tools to plot the altimetric height. We have concept like hypsographic curves, okay, and so on. These are relief aspects. Now, just to help you, okay, look up these concepts, this is page number 353, again, Geomorphology by Savindra Singh. I have an older edition, but thankfully, despite all the edition changes, the page number remains exactly the same. That makes our work a bit easy. So, I'm reading out something to help you understand what is morphometry or drainage basins. This is 353. The first column, I'm reading out some sentences. Like, the first sentence says, measurement of shape or geometry of any natural form, be it plant, animal or relief features, is termed morphometry. So any type of measurement is morphometry. Now, in this study, you can look up the last 7-8 lines. It says, fluvial morphometry includes the consideration of linear, areal and relief aspects of a fluvially originated drainage basin. So it includes linear, areal and relief aspects. The linear aspects deal with the hierarchical order of streams, stream numbers, lengths of stream segments and various relationship among them and the related morphometric laws. This is what I have listed, that these three are part of the linear aspects of studying fluvial morphometry or basin morphometry. It continues and says, the areal aspects include the analysis of the basin perimeters, the basin shape, both geometrical and topographical, the basin area and the relative or the related morphometric laws. And finally, if you look at the fourth line from top, the second column, it says, the relief aspect incorporates, besides hypsometric, clinographic and altimetric analysis, the study of absolute relief, relative relief, relief ratios, average slope, dissection index, among the others. So I just gave an idea to you, what is the scope of the idea called as basin morphometry. Now, I'll explain each of this briefly so that you understand what we are trying to study. So we are taking one of the first topics under the concept of linear aspects of drainage morphometry. Having explained what do I mean by linear aspects, areal aspects and the relief aspects. Under linear aspects, there are three terms. I am taking the first one, what is stream ordering? Now, in the study of a drainage basin where there are many rivers, where one river will be the main river, which is fed by tributaries and its subtributaries, we are studying how are the rivers related to one another in terms of the hierarchy. So it says that stream order is a study of the hierarchical position of streams. What I mean by this is, if this is the main river and there are tributaries and subtributaries, what we are asking is, how do we relate the main river with the other rivers that feed it? There are two ways of doing this. You might either consider the main river as river 1 and then tell us the other rivers, this could be river 2, the 2 is fed by a smaller river which is 3, the 3 could be fed by a smaller river called 4. You start from the main river called as the trunk river and then move upwards and start numbering them. The other way of doing it is you can start from the head stream. Okay, you can consider the smallest river which has no tributaries as one, and this one could combine with other small rivers to become a bigger one called as two. Many such twos can join together to become the next level called as three, and so on until we get the highest level called as the trunk river. So these are two methods of relating the rivers in terms of their hierarchy. Now there are many who have suggested the schemes for this. One of the earlier name is Gravelius. Now the method of Gravelius was he would start with the biggest river and then move upstream. Whereas the more popular scheme was given by Horton. Horton would start from the smaller river and then move towards the larger trunk river. So this is what the concept is. No big mathematics here. You just had to know 3-4 terms. That this is a way of studying how the rivers in the river system are linked to one another in terms of their hierarchical positions and what are the schemes by which we try to depict this. Now, if you want to read up something, and I suggest all of you should open up books to have one quick reading of some sections. It's not that the books are going to be the only source, but with the books what happens is the concepts gets consolidated, right? So please again open up Geomorphology by Samindra Singh, and this time open up page number 358. The second column, the heading is stream ordering. You read the first sentence of this section, it says, stream ordering refers to determination of hierarchical position of a stream within a drainage basin. A river basin consists of its several branches having different positions in the basin area, and they have their own morphometric characteristics, and therefore it becomes necessary to locate the relative position of a segment of the basin so that the hierarchical organization of a stream segment can be visualized. Now, there are many schemes. Your books will talk about 3-4 of them. I want to limit the schemes to only two of them. One is the Gravelius scheme of stream ordering, which is the next paragraph in this column. And the next one is the Horton scheme of stream ordering, okay, given below that. So in the Gravelius scheme, what he does is he first identified the trunk stream. The trunk stream is the main river. The trunk stream, by tracing it from its outlet. So if this is the main river, this is the outlet. You trace the river from the outlet upwards, outlet, to its source on the basis of the greatest width. So this is the greatest width, then a bit smaller width, then a bit smaller, and so on. So greatest width, discharge, headward branching and junction angles, and thus the trunk stream was assigned the position of the first order. The main river is said to be first order, and thereafter the other rivers. The other scheme is Horton scheme. The next section it says, R.E. Horton, the American engineer, presented his scheme of stream ordering, which was opposite of the scheme of Gravelius. According to Horton, ordering of stream begins from fingertip tributaries. It's like if you imagine your palm as the rivers and the drainage systems, your hand is the main trunk river, then the fingers become the tributaries. So you start from the fingertips. The first stream which does not have any tributaries, the smallest stream in the upslopes, you name that as one. Okay, you name this as one. And one combined together to give us a bigger stream, we call that bigger stream as two. And such big streams will give us the next bigger stream, it's called as three. You start from fingertip towards the main trunk. That's what this paragraph says. According to Horton, ordering of stream begins from fingertip tributaries, which do not have their own feeders, no tributaries. Rather, they're independent in terms of supply of water. Such fingertip streams are designated as first order stream. Two first order stream when joined together form the second order stream. Then two second order stream will join to form the third order stream, and so on. Now in this, there is one rule that he follows. He says, if this is first order and this is first order, what we get is a second order. if this is first order, this is first order, what we get is a second order. Two second order streams combine, what we get is a third order. Okay, we don't say 2 plus 2 equal to 4. So second order stream plus second order stream, we get the third order. But if there is another river here which is the first order, so what I'm getting is first order river with a second order river. Now I don't call this as third, I still call it as 2. Essentially, for the next higher order, I must have two similar lower orders. So 1 and 1 become 2, 2 and 2 become 3, but 2 and 1 will not become 3, 2 and 1 will remain as 2. Similarly, 3 and 3 will become 4, but if 3 combines with the second one, it remains as 3. So if this was the second order stream with 2 order here, so this is first order, second order. So what I get from this junction, because I already have got the third order here. So this third order and second order, now this river continues to be the third order river. So that's the rule that he follows, and the lines that follow this paragraph has that. It says, if you look at the next page 360, okay, look at the third line onwards. Thus, according to Horton's scheme, when two streams of same order meet, they form the next higher order, and each stream can receive tributaries of lower order than its own. In other words, the stream order increases only when two streams of same order join together. If the stream or streams of lower order join a stream of a higher order, so if there is a lower order stream joining a higher order stream, the order of the receiving stream does not increase. So 1 and 2 does not become 3, it remains as 2. So that's the concept of stream ordering. Now, along with the textbook of geomorphology by Savinder Singh, I think all of you know about this book by Rupa Publication, Made Simple Series in Geography. Now, this is another of a very important reference books, and couple of stream aspects are mentioned in this book too. And I'll recommend that you pause the video for some time and get this book so that I can tell you what all to mark from this textbook too. So from this book, we have page number 53. So I'm talking about Physical Geography Made Simple Part 1. So it's a pretty old book now, okay, but I still treasure it. One of my favorite books. So this is the chapter number 5 page number 53. There's a section called as River Basin. And there this we have the concept of fluvial morphometry. So it says, in order to facilitate comparisons between basins, a hierarchy of stream order is used. This was originally proposed by Horton, but the amended system by Schewer and Stroller are the ones that is generally used. So along with Gravelius and Horton, we also had a scheme given by Stroller. I'll suggest please skip all of that. And in page number 54, there is one nice diagram that you can look up. It tells us how 1 and 1 can become 2, 1 and 2 remain as 2, 2 and 3 remain as 3, so on. So it's a nice description in that, so you can look that up. So that explains the concept of stream ordering. Now, this is a very simple concept called as bifurcation ratio, just a ratio that we have. Again, Savinder Singh, Geomorphology, page number 361. I must reiterate this, okay, and tell you repeatedly, please treat these videos not as presentations or short movies. Okay, these videos are pre-recorded. I expect that you sit down with a pencil and a pen and a paper. And as I teach, you should be learning from this. And you cannot learn if you simply listen to what I'm saying. You have to jot down something. So please pause the video where required and take down some notes. Open up a textbook and keep referring to it, okay? So even if the video is about 8, 9, 10 minutes, the learning from the video could take you about 20, 25 minutes, okay? At the convenience of your time and place. So come back now. So we are discussing bifurcation ratio, page number 361. It's just a ratio that you should know about. It says bifurcation ratio is related to the branching pattern of drainage network, is defined as the number of streams of a given order to the number of streams of the next higher order. So see, I want to know the bifurcation ratio of 1 and 2. So number of streams of 1. So I have got 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. You count all of that. Okay. Then you count number of, okay, 2s. You have 2 here, I have 2 here, I have 2 here, and so on. Similarly, I can also compare 3. We have got different, okay, 3 streams also. And we take a ratio. It says bifurcation ratio is the number of streams of a given order to the number of streams of the next higher order, and is expressed in terms of the equation. The bifurcation ratio is n nu by n nu plus 1. So number of streams in first order by number of streams in second order, or number of stream in second order by number of stream in the third order, and so on. And remember, this is a ratio. It does not have any units. That was one definition. And then we have this small concept called as what is the law of stream numbers. Now, stream numbers is another concept in the discussion of basin morphometry. Stream number tells us how diverse and how big the system is in terms of its tributaries. So page number 362, okay, you have to read this sentence a bit more carefully because it looks like a mathematical one, but pretty simple. It says the law of stream numbers relate to the definite relationship between the orders of the basin and stream numbers. R. E. Houghton, law of stream number, states that the number of stream segments of a successively lower order in a given basin tend to form a geometric series beginning with the single segment of the highest order. So it is very well explained here. It says that imagine there is a river that has 6 level of orders. So we have got the highest one is level 6, then we have level 5, we have order 4, order 3, 2, and 1. Okay, so big river Ganga, the main trunk stream, its tributary, and so on. So they say there are 6 orders here. And it says if the bifurcation ratio, okay, the bifurcation ratio of 6 to 5 to 5 to 4 and forth and so on. If the bifurcation ratio is some number, the example it says, say the number is, okay, 4. In that case, it says that there is some relationship between them, which is that if the main trunk stream is 1, okay, then there will be 4 number of tributaries that make, okay, the main trunk. There will be 4 into 4 number of third order, okay, which will make up the system. There will be 16 into 4, which is 64 number of the third order, which will be part of the system. So it's almost like a geometric progression based on the bifurcation ratio, which is the basis of this type of ordering. So you just have to explain this. Like I said, this is just giving you a sense of completion that you have touched upon certain small random topics. Do not go too deep into these concepts, just enough in case they ask you a short note on a couple of these terms. I hope that helps you and helps you revise also from the books that I have mentioned. Thank you.